not a car.
like you gotta pause the game, sit down, hands folded, eyes closed, head down, and you're like, all right,
me again, Karna, Lord.
I've been really good this year. Maybe you'll allow me to DI this friend.
So
speaking of DI, Pichu, I picked up this character for a little bit. I think Pichu's awesome, but the thing that made me like kind of question him is that Pichu's all about DI traps. Okay, you have to really, really react to like how that your opponent DIs and stuff, because some things are true on certain DIs and some things aren't, and you have like optimal punishes based on each. But same thing goes with Sheik. I mean, we're going to see another Sheik on stream with Karna. This is the first I've personally seen of Karna Sheik.
Karna Sheik actually did take a game off of Grayson's Rob. He's formerly Texas PR in Smash 4 off this character. So he still has a lot of love for this character. But like, of course,
I mean, he beat Grayson because he knows how to DI up air.
Yeah, he knows how to DI up air. Your propaganda has been proven. But yeah, this is like the battle between Void's inner demons, the characters that he both want to main. We shall see who's going to be the better between the two. Marcel has been really showing up, and great anti-air with the up tilt too on reaction. Marcel actually mained this character in Smash 4 as well, so he knows how to deal for a whole bunch. Especially the,
Give Yo! Him the toes! The toes! Please! Get out of my face!
I brought my pussy pajama today. Did you?
Did you?
Yo, what incredible punch from Marcel. The punch of Bouncing Fish. On the tippy toes of the
I do believe Marcel is seeded to win.
Yeah, Marcel will probably be seeded to win between these two. He's gotten a lot of great wins lately. He actually did be Grayson himself, actually, about 2 or 3 weeks back.
Oh, interesting. I didn't know that.
Yeah. So, and he's also beating Jama as well, I think last week, too. So he's got...
Number 10.
Yeah. So PR wins under his belt. He's definitely one of our favorites out here in DFW.
The spacing.
Yeah.
Okay. Dash tap. I'm not sure that was good DI.
Well, the good thing for Sheik in this particular matchup is that she finally gets to feel like a real character at this point. She gets to kill a little bit on the earlier side.
But you also die at 4.
True.
Pichu would kill you.
Yeah, Pichu is a little bit stronger than Pikachu. Or the rat.
Like, put the glass in glass cannon.
Yeah.
Like, that's what Pichu is. It's a super, super, both characters super.
Ooh! Oh, that killed
Never
at 60.
Never DI in again.
That killed at 60.
Never DI in again.
If you watch this particular, like, if you watch this particular VOD, Lord Sakurai, please nerf Sheik. Ray Sheik is destroying this game. Ray Sheik is destroying this game, all right?
He was at 90. That wasn't even a lot of rage. Marcel just DI'd her wrong.
Silence, my propaganda.
Oh, okay, my bad. I'm not one to, like, cancel other people's propaganda. That's not me.
He's been getting really a lot off these jabs because he knows. Oh, my God. What? Oh, he almost had the
confirm. Why did he die?
Good air dodge, and the up air is not gonna kill? No, not yet.
If that killed, I was gonna pop off. That would have been so great.
Yeah, that should be death. Not at all, actually. Still living out here.
The coolest things never kill.
But you know, sometimes SDs kill.
SDs do kill.
Yeah.
Yeah. If you run off the ledge, you die.
Turns out, if you miss it for your recovery, you just kind of like, you know, you lose the set.
True.
Or lose the game. All right, so Marcel down. Karna Sheik really kind of showing him in the last bit with the up air confirmed.
Karna Sheik, pretty good.
Karna Sheik is very, very good. I said before, once again, a phenomenal player, formerly Texas PR. The funny thing about Karna is that the more and more you talk to him, the more you realize there's some stuff in the game that he's not even applying. Like, there was a long period of Smash 4.
Karna's where, both brilliant and, like, the most three-head individual.
Exactly, yeah. Like, I love, like, don't get me wrong, I think Karna's, like, great player, but he'd be like, man, like, I'm supposed to SDI Bayo combos? I'm like, yes. unless you like dying. That's just natural talent that comes from Karna himself.
We're going to see another Town and City pick. Town and City been a favorite stage tonight. Uh-oh.
Well, I guess this will help Marcel because he was dying off the top least twice. Yeah. So if he gets another hit with those up airs again, he won't have to worry about it too much.
Also, Pichu F smash.
True. Pichu F tilt.
Pichu really does kill off the side way more than the top. I don't think I... Like, unless you up smash for some reason.
Yeah, unless you get the hard read, the up smash.
Uh-oh. That's missing, but that's going to cost you.
Oh, man. He was looking for the reset of resets. If he got that down air, that might have led to another up air, actually.
Yeah, he couldn't get another drag down up air to F tilt because the platform was in the way. That is the true loop. That is something you can do. But... Ooh, we read the jump, but the fade back with the jump really saved Marcel there.
Marcel's, these guys are, wow, okay. The Usman, okay. You know, we brought it up earlier, maybe it's a good idea to use it, it's a good answer.
On certain DIs, it does combo into Thunder.
Does it really?
Yes. It is kind of a dumb move.
Oh. Oh, the back air getting beat out by the forward air. Connor trying to get a read with the back air himself. And the up smash once again coming out.
What a dumb move.
I'm really surprised myself to use the up smash here.
It's my dad up smash.
I mean, hey, if it works, it works, man. This is the point where I think Connor's gonna struggle to kill just a tad bit unless he gets like a wall just like back air. Most of his stuff is not gonna confirm at this point. You see him kind of looking for it.
How's it gonna do? He's struggling.
Yeah, he's struggling. He's getting almost like he's winning a lot of the neutral. The back air not even coming close to killing actually. Trying to go for the edge guard.
Doesn't quite get being split too much. Thank you, Tom.
This is not normal. You don't see a Pichu normally eating hits and actually living. 181 right now.
God, nerf Pichu weight.
Shut up. Silence you. All right, once again, trying with Pichu.
Why did that Pichu live to 200?
It's Sheik, man. Sheik.
Karna's only at 44, too.
Yeah.
Like, he didn't even get anything off of that.
Yeah, he didn't really lose too much of exchange. And this is something you can bring back up easily. But Pichu having any lead versus this character might look great. I mean, living up to near 200%, that could be a really great showing for what's going to happen in the rest of the game.
Turns out not dying is pretty great in fighting games.
Oh, yeah. Pretty sick, actually. Great shield for Raphne from Karna. Getting the up air, too. He's brought him almost completely back already. Yo.
Oh, the shield. That exchange was so terrible.
It was. It felt like anybody could die. Oh, you tried to shield grab Pichu? How dare you?
Spacing. And remember, Karna is up a game.
Yeah, Karna is up a game. He was able to kind of like destroy some stocks in the last game, but this game is not looking so fortunate.
A lot of fortunate things did happen. And it even ended on a Marcel FD, so that is something. Run off.
Yeah, we were trying to go, I think it'd go for a lid front there, but unfortunately just fell off.
Oh, that was crap.
Oh my god, the amount of falling, the hitbox not looking out there, but the back air able to get a 2-spot, and Karna can still close it out before we go to a game 3, or a potential game 3.
Yeah, once again, the lead was, or is Marcellus, but like, not huge. He didn't get a lot off of living.
Yeah, I mean, that's the one thing too about being like a disturbingly light character like Pichu too, like, at like forward, when you start getting hit with the forward air, they start to start sending you off stage. Like, those are the neutral exchanges that you're not winning, and you're just going to be ledge trapped by Sheik the whole time. Back air, gets a full stage control. Try to be the jump with it. Another back air, 94%. It's not looking too great for Mr. Kazanaki.
And oh, he jumped into it.
Yeah.
The thing, though, is that Marcel had not used that all game yet. Or at least all set thus far. So, no. I mean, that was pretty darn fresh tactic to use.
Yeah, that is a new mix-up that he provided. And now Karna has to respect that option.
That's true.
I'm pretty sure that covered, like, three options. I think it covered tournament winner. I think it covered neutral get-up. And it covered that.
Yeah.
So, very, very smart option for Marcel.
And in those areas, you don't really want to roll a whole bunch, because if you roll, you just like almost everybody covers roll instead.
We were talking about that earlier, too.
Yeah.
People always cover roll, people always cover jump. Or everyone jumps too much.
Yeah. A lot of people are kind of like neutral get up at the stuff. So, I mean, with the forward smash from Pichu, that's
I mean, that was kind of neutral get up.
Yeah, that was like super active, so that might have just blown him up. Going to smash, really good stage for Karna here, I think. He's going to have, he's going to be really close to him the whole time. He should be able to just get a lot of harassment, and the blast zones on the side should be able to help him out. And with that middle platform, he might be able to get some more of his wards up here or kill confirm.
Absolutely.
He's
got to win neutral first.
So far, Marcel seems to be outplaying him a little bit more in the neutral.
I would like to see Marcel grab a little bit more. Peach's grab is actually like really broken, especially the roll cancel boost grab tech, where you like input a roll or a dash roll into a grab, and it like extends Peach's range like stupid amount.
Super good, and I love the confidence from Karna there to go for the grab behind after getting hit on shield. He just knew my man was gonna shield, respect his option.
That's a wrap grab. The up smash.
Really good up smash. He covered like if he just in the most obscure part. It was the most obscure part right behind him.
Up throw. Reads the air dodge.
Good air dodge away. Decided to. Oh my goodness. What was that? Was that down throw up there?
I believe so.
Really nice stuff from Mr. Kazanaki. Able to take that first stock. Unless he was able to run away with the percentage lead. Last game, he did not. Was not able to run away with it.
Nope.
Run away with it whatsoever. In this game, he's not given an opportunity either.
What Pichu told me, since down smash has iframes, One Pichu told me that down smash is a better anti-air than up smash.
It really is. Because it has invincibility. I mean, like, you get somebody jumping in on you, they kind of get blown up for it. They kind of die. It's super ambiguous sometimes of where you're going to actually have the DI.
Yeah, absolutely.
Nice that they'll put the buck off stage.
Can you believe that a year ago, some people might have thought this matchup was unplayable?
You know, I wouldn't have blamed them either.
And that Pichu won it?
Would not blame them either.
Crazy.
Oh, the F still puts him off stage. Goes for the F smash. Luckily, does not get hit with it despite being at inches away from death. And Karn's ledge trapping is absolutely phenomenal, too. Pressing a lot of buttons on
his shield. He tried to jab check his shield.
Trying to get the bouncy fist. He's going for anything. He keeps going for his ledge trap, and he keeps actually misinputting, I believe.
Yeah, I'm not a huge fan of that. Oh, catch him. Ooh. One misinput cost him that stock.
I mean, well, it's still she gets 60, though. She can still just blow up if Marcel gets the right read. Try to go for
yeah,
it right there.
There it is.
Yeah. Think Carter learner's lesson in shield grabbing in this game. Probably not the play sometimes.
Either way. Not quite getting out of there. Oh, it doesn't get the strong spot.
Yeah, if you got the strong spot, that would have been one dead ninja.
We'll throw, reads the jump.
Completely different game that we saw in game two. We've seen Carter being a lot more dominant now. Gives up the air dodge, but doesn't give up the directional air dodge in the way that Marcel wanted.
Now, gonna be able to drift away from Marcel's pressure.
Good pressure from Karner, too. Just checking the shield.
Get out of my face. He's punishing those thunders really, really well. Hit a button.
Karner realized he had more to lose there, now on change. And another back air is gonna be able to end that stock.
That's it. Now, I mean, Pichu can't rob you.
Yeah, Pichu is absolutely has the robbery potential.
Like, but sometimes you'll just die. Uh-oh.
Karn is playing out of his mind. He wants to stock really, really bad. But Marcel is going to get the cheese! Almost dying at like 20%. The F-Smash kills him, and Karn gets robbed by Marcel. Despite having an incredible lead.
I spoke it into existence.